Hi everybody, this is Jolynn at Namaste Yoga Studio in Northfield, Ohio. We're giving you some stretches for your pre-run. So as you inhale, stretch all the way up, coming into a crescent pose, bend over to the left. And just stretch through your ribs, give yourself some space to breathe as you run. And inhale, come back to center and stretch to the right. And do that again to each side, stretch over to the left, keeping your knees soft and your core strong. Inhale, come back to center and stretch over to the right. Come back to center. We'll come into a little chair pose by bringing your feet a little bit wider than your hips. And just bring your hands onto your knees, starting to warm up the quads, warm up the glutes and the hip flexors. And then stretch your hands forward. Keep your heart nice and open. Inhale, stretch up to a little back bend, just really gentle. And then sweep your hands back next to your hips. Curl your chin in. Inhale, stretch up. And we'll just come into the sweeping chair a few times, just letting your breath guide the movement. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, rise up, little stretch, and let your arms go. We'll come into a hamstring, calf, quad stretch by coming into a pyramid pose or a runner's pose. So stepping the left foot forward, you'll step the right foot back about walking distance, and your feet are hip-width apart. So if you stand right foot behind the left, it'll be challenging to balance, so we want our feet hip-width apart. Interlace your hands so you're getting a nice heart and shoulder opener, again, making lots of space to breathe. Take a breath in here. Hug and tone your belly in and bow forward. See if you can keep your hips even, so sending that left hip slightly back. Keep the elbows soft. Now, probably for most runners, this is quite a bit of a stretch. If you can go a little further, feel free to go further, but don't push. So we don't want to stress out the hamstrings and the hips. And with your in-breath, rise up, stretch your arms up, and bend a little into that left knee. So you get a nice stretch through the right calf, drawing that right inner thigh back. Pull your belly in and just stretch up and long, maybe taking a gentle back bend here. As you exhale, let your hands go. And we'll step and switch. So right foot forward, left foot back. Again, a little bit further than walking distance. Take a breath in, interlace your hands and open your heart. Keep the heart wide open as you bow and fold. Again, tapping that right hip back this time. Hug your low belly in. Keep the elbows soft so the center of your chest expands forward. With your inhale, lift up. A little bend in the right knee this time. Coming into a short warrior one. Keep stretching back through the left heel. Raise your arms. Feel a nice stretch through that left calf, drawing that left inner thigh back. Really root strongly into the four corners of the left foot. And as you exhale, release, step forward. We'll take one more stretch, getting that great big quad muscle. So maybe you can find some balance in your right foot. Maybe you need to hold on to a tree or whatever you've got going on. Draw your heel in towards your hip as you root into your right foot. Drop your left knee down to the mat, starting to stretch out that quad. Maybe raise your arm again, just making some space for your breath. Stretch long through that left femur bone, left muscle of the quad, and then release, and we'll take the other side. Stretching long through the left arm. Take a breath in, and a breath out. One more deep breath in, stretching long. Stretch the front of the right quad, and exhale, release. One more little thing for ankle stability. We're just gonna take the tiniest of tree poses. So rooting into the right foot, I just want you to bring your left heel towards your right ankle. And this helps with stability. So wobbling is okay here. We need ankle stability as a runner. So maybe you even just hover those left toes above the mat. Maybe you stretch long again, and always gazing at the mat helps you become a little bit more stable. So feel a little tiny wobble to that right ankle, but that starts to strengthen the right ankle. And then release, we'll come to the other side, lift and spread your left toes, and we'll bring the right heel into the left ankle, maybe again hovering those right toes, maybe lifting your arms, taking your gaze down to the mat or to the ground or to the grassy earth in front of you. And as you exhale, release, and we hope you have a nice run. Thank you so much for joining us. Look at our website for some classes for yoga, yoga for athletes, yoga for runners.